Hello students, welcome to PVK chemistry classes. So in this video we are going to discuss the physical and chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. So first of all, the physical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Physical state, first point, physical state. Formaldehyde is a gas. All other aldehydes and ketones up to carbon number 11 are liquids. Greater than carbon number 11, these compounds are exist in the form of solids at normal temperature. Second one, second point, order. Lower aldehydes are unpleasant order. Lower aldehydes are unpleasant order, while higher aldehydes and ketones are pleasant order. Solubility, third point, solubility. Lower members of carbonyl compounds are readily soluble in water because of the polar nature of the carbonyl carbon. As the carbon number increases, the solubility decreases. Carbon number increases, that is molecular weight increases, solubility decreases, and tendency to form the hydrogen bond also decreases. Boiling point and melting point. The boiling point and melting point of carbonyl compounds are explained on the basis of their molecular weight. As the carbon number increases, melting and boiling point are increases, or simply say melting and boiling points are directly proportional to molecular weight and inversely proportional to branching. So I already told you in the previous classes, as the branching, the same molecular formula but a different isomeric form. Suppose the compounds having branched chain, the van der Waal poses decreases. Van der Waal poses decreases means their melting or the boiling points also low when comparing with the normal chain compounds. Normal chain compounds. For example, comparing the boiling points of formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, and acetone. The boiling point of formaldehyde is -21°C, acetaldehyde is +21°C, and acetone is +56°C. And the reactivity also depends upon the nature of the groups attached to the carbonyl carbon. This is methanol. Methanol is more reactive than ethanol. Ethanol is more reactive than propanol. Suppose the question may ask in the examination, methanol is more reactive than ethanol. Why? Because here very very small dummy groups are attached to the carbonyl carbon, and here on methyl groups, as the bulkiness increases, the reactivity also decreases, or simply say the plus I effect increases. The reactivity of the carbonyl compound decreases. Reactivity of carbonyl compound decreases. And some simple points about this carbonyl compound. Formaldehyde, the 40% of aqueous solution of formaldehyde is called as pyrmalin. What is pyrmalin? 40% of aqueous solution of formaldehyde is called pyrmalin. It is used for preservative agent, for biological specimens, and disinfectant, and also act as a antiseptic. Formaldehyde and lactose gives parma mint. It is used for throat infection. Parma mint, which is used for throat infection. So these are the some physical properties of these aldehydes and ketones. Now we are going to discuss the chemical reactions or chemical properties of aldehydes. Chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones are classified into four categories: nucleophilic addition, reduction reaction, oxidation reaction, reaction with alkalis, reduction reaction, oxidation reaction, reaction with alkalis, dilute alkalis and concentrated alkalis. First of all, addition reaction, nucleophilic addition. Nucleophilic addition, hydrogen cyanide, addition of hydrogen cyanide, acetaldehyde reacts with hydrogen cyanide. What is the nucleophile generated for this process? Cyanide, CN minus act as a nucleophile. The nucleophile attack this carbonyl carbon so that the bond shift towards oxygen. So the oxygen carries negative charge abstract this proton, CH3CHOHCN, acetaldehyde cyanohydride. This is one of the very important conversion in the examination point of view. Acetaldehyde reacts with hydrogen cyanide gives acetaldehyde cyanohydrin. Once this compound is formed, it undergoes hydrolysis. Acetaldehyde cyanohydrin on hydrolysis gives lactic acid, CH3CHOHCOOH. Listen, cyano group, in any place cyano group present, it undergo hydrolysis, finally yield the product called acid, carboxylic acid. This is a lactic acid, is an optically active compound. Lactic acid is an optically active compound. It rotates the plane polarized light either in the clockwise direction or it is in the anti-clockwise direction because of asymmetric carbon atom. Once this compound is formed, this compounds undergo oxidation. The secondary alkali group on oxidation gives ketone, pyruvic acid. Acetaldehyde, in majority of the textbooks up to this term only present, but the continuation reaction is very important. So acetaldehyde cyanohydrin on hydrolysis gives lactic acid on hydrolysis gives pyruvic acid is a precursor in glycolysis process, you know that. And next addition of similar addition reaction takes place with the help of benzaldehyde. Suppose the benzaldehyde reacts with the hydrogen cyanide gives benzaldehyde cyanohydrin, which on further hydrolysis gives mandelic acid, CHOHCOOH. Mandelic acid is a product, benzaldehyde on hydrolysis gives. Addition of sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3, so whatever may be the compound can take place. All the carbonyl compounds undergoes this addition reaction with sodium bisulfite except benzophenone. Benzophenone does not undergo, gives any addition product with sodium bisulfite because of bulky phenyl groups or high the due to the steric effect that is leads to the bulky phenyl group, two bulky phenyl groups attached with carbonyl carbon. Therefore, it does not give any addition product with benzophenone, does not provide any addition product with sodium bisulfite. All the other compounds, acetaldehyde, acetone, benzaldehyde, even acetophenone also gives addition product with sodium bisulfite. acetone CH3 C double bond O CH3. It is written like this. It is sodium bisulfate is written like this, cosona, negative part. This negative part attack this carbonyl carbon, this bond shift towards the oxygen. So CH3 COH CH3 O SOONA, acetone sodium bisulfate, acetone sodium bisulfate is the addition product. So, the addition reaction takes place, addition of sodium bisulfate. Then Grignard addition, Grignard addition. So, Grignard addition, we already discussed in hydroxy derivative parts, Grignard addition, Grignard reagent, formaldehyde reacts with Grignard reagent gives primary alcohol, acetaldehyde reacts with Grignard reagent gives secondary alcohol, acetone reacts with Grignard reagent gives tertiary alcohol. For example, benzaldehyde reacts with the Grignard reagent, CH3 MgI Grignard reagent, benzaldehyde reacts with the Grignard reagent in the presence of ether. What happens? This carbanion attack this carbonyl carbon. Carbonyl carbon, benzaldehyde, carbanion attack this carbonyl carbon, so that it gives the addition product like this, C6H5CCH3HOMgI. Once this product is formed, it undergo acid hydrolysis, gives C6H5CH3OH. So, this is the methyl phenyl carbinol. MgIOH. So, Grignard addition. Fourth, addition of ammonia and its derivatives. Ammonia reacts with formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, acetone and benzaldehyde. So, each and every case different reaction takes place. For example, formaldehyde reacts with ammonia, gives a condensed product called urotropin, urotropin. Acetaldehyde reacts with ammonia gives aldehyde type of product. Acetone reacts with ammonia gives diacetone amine. Benzaldehyde reacts with ammonia gives hydrobenzamide. First, formaldehyde. 6 molecules of formaldehyde, 4 molecules of ammonia. Here 4, 3 are 12 hydrogen, here 6 oxygen. Gives 6 molecules of water is eliminated. So, remaining C gives to 6 times N4. Kexa methylene tetramine. Kexa methylene tetramine is called urotropin. This urotropin acts as a urinary antiseptic. how to draw the structure of urotropin. First you draw benzene like structure. Here you start from nitrogen CH2, nitrogen CH2, nitrogen CH2, then proceed with methylene group and nitrogen. So in between the two nitrogen add one methylene group. So this is the structure of urotropin. Urotropin acts as a urinary antiseptic. Acetaldehyde reaction with acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde CH3 C double bond to H. Ammonia is written like this, HNH2. This nitrogen containing lone pair of electron attack this carbonyl compound so that the bond shift towards oxygen. So form an addition product CH3 CH OH NH. NH2 is written HH. This hydrogen and oxygen OH. Eliminate the molecule of water. It gives CH3CH double bond NH minus H2. It's the aldehyde type of product is obtained. Aldehyde type of product. Acetaldehyde as the product. Then acetone. How acetone reacts with ammonia? How acetone reacts with ammonia? Two molecules of acetone reacts with one molecule of ammonia gives the compound called diacetone amine. It is written like this. First one molecule of acetone CH3. Now for the reaction it is written like this, CH3 double bond O. So ammonia HNH2 and another one molecule of acetone, it is written like this, two molecules of acetone. So these three, eliminate the molecule of water, it gives CH3 CCH3 NH2 CH2 CO CH3 diacetone amine. Benzaldehyde reacts with ammonia. C6H5 CH double bond. Three molecules of benzaldehyde. H2NH. On heating, eliminate the molecule of water. Three molecules of water eliminate like this. So the product is C6H5 CH double bond N CH double bond N CH C6H5 plus three molecule of water, hydrobenzamide as the product. So acetaldehyde, formaldehyde reacts with ammonia gives urotropin, acetaldehyde reacts with ammonia gives aldehyde type of product, acetone reacts with ammonia gives diacetone amine, benzaldehyde reacts with ammonia gives hydrobenzamide. So the derivatives of ammonia derivatives, some of the ammonia derivative and product obtained is written in the blackboard. First one is hydroxylamine, NH2OH hydroxylamine, hydrazine, phenylhydrazine, semicarboside, 2,4 dinitrophenylhydrazine. 2,4 dinitrophenylhydrazine. This is very, very simple reaction. First, you look at the ammonia derivatives. All these ammonia derivatives consist of NH2 as the common group. NH2 as the common group. Aldehydes, ketones, all are react with these ammonia derivatives to give the product. What are the aldehydes involving the process? Formaldehyde, acetaldehyde, benzaldehyde, acetophenone, benzophenone. All of the functional derivatives gives addition product with this ammonia derivatives. How this reaction takes place? First of all, acetone reacts with the hydroxyl amine. So for all this reactive part, that is NH2 is the reactive part. The reactive part is written like this: NH, OH. After that, whatever may be the functional groups or the derivatives or groups present, don't bother about it. This nitrogen containing lone pair of electron attack this carbonyl carbon and the bond shift towards oxygen to form an addition compound CH3, CHOH, NHOH. So all this compound, suppose we are conducting the reaction with acetone and this hydrazine. So you get CH3, CCH3OH, NHOH. Right? So once this compound is formed, eliminate the molecule of water. Water is eliminated. It gives the product called CH3CH(NOH) plus water. The product is oxime. If you are using acetaldehyde, acetaldoxime. Acetone, acetone oxime. Benzaldehyde, benzaldoxime, etc. So, benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde reacts with the semicarbazide. NH2CO NH2. So, whatever may be the derivative used, you should return in the form of NH2 is written in the form of HNH. So, this nitrogen containing lone pair of electron attack this carbonyl carbon and form an addition product like this. So, C6H5 CHOH NH CO NH NH2. After this, eliminate the molecule of water gives C6H5 CH(NH) CO NH NH2. So the benzaldehyde semicarbazide. The product is acetaldehyde oxime, acetone hydrazone, acetone phenylhydrazone, semicarbazone, 2,4 dinitrophenylhydrazone. So, these are the derivatives of ammonia. So, I will explain these derivatives of ammonia with the various carbonyl compounds in a very simple manner. So, all this part having the NH2 as the reactive part. This reactive part only take place in the chemical reaction and give the product like this. Suppose you are taking benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde reacts with the hydroxylamine gives benzaldoxime. Benzaldehyde reacts with the phenylhydrazine gives benzaldehyde phenylhydrazone. So these are about the chemical reactions of first part of the chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones. So I hope all should understood the chemical reactions. You practice very well. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment box. Thank you for watching. Thank you.